So hello Darilis, welcome back to another episode. You know what, I feel a little bit weird making this video. I don't know, but unfortunately it's unbelievable. I'm like camera shy anymore. Like, I'm not used to making videos as before, but it's crazy, but it's been a few months from my last video. I am a little bit embarrassed due to my lack of discipline, because to be honest, there's not a reason as to why I stopped, but the reason why I'm gonna make this video is to catch up. Boom. The thing goes grrr, pa, pa, ta, 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 pa, skitty, kick, pa, 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 and the poop, poop, brr, boom. Like, I feel like before I come here and tell you anything about my business and anything about how I'm handling everything, I feel like you guys should know the reason why I stopped making videos. Not only did I stop making videos, but I got a long break from social media. Like, this is coming from a person that will always make videos, always sing on social media, always post pictures, always post each and every location that I went. I was active. I lived an active life on my social media. Now, what happened? I'm just gonna say this: mental breakdown and mental fuck-ups are real. Mentally, I found myself on a position that I was, you know what, I don't care about anything. My life is gotten so hard and so messed up that I don't even know, like, what's going on. But now I do know what's going on, and I'm here making this video. If you find yourself in the same position, just cut everything off. If you find yourself in a position that you're not yourself, you're procrastinating, you're not as dedicated, you have a business and your sales dropped. Bro, I went from making 10K to making $0 a month on my business. The fuck went wrong? I'm gonna tell you what went wrong. So this is just a video to catch up, to let you know what happened, how I feel about everything, what am I doing to change it, because if there's somebody to blame here, will be me. Because making myself the victim is not gonna help me, because the only person that has to have accountability for my actions is me, nobody else. So anyway, to start off, I don't know if you've seen my previous videos. If this is your first video that you see on my channel, I started off selling lashes online, and I did that for about 2 years, and then I started my lash business on a vending machine. I decided to open a location in Pennsylvania. That was my first location. And then I opened the second one in Pennsylvania, and then I opened the third one in Pembroke Pines, Florida, the fourth one in Orlando, and the fifth one back in PA. So this has been my journey since I started all the way until now. My business online, I had to close the business online due to whatever I'm gonna tell you right now throughout this video. But the vending machines, I still have it. I still have the 5 locations. It's been a hassle because the last time that I went to, for instance, the one in Pembroke Pine was like 3 months ago. That's the lack of discipline that I've been having. And it's crazy, because when you find yourself in this position, it's so hard to just be like, you know what, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. Like, I feel like right now, this is my rock bottom. And I'm just slowly coming back up to where I was and the level that I was. But just know that if this is you and you had a business and you, for some underlying reason, you had to close it, just know that life goes on, that at least when you try to come back to your business, you're not gonna start from scratch. You're gonna have a base. Like right now, the only thing that doesn't make me feel as bad is that at least I kept my followers. I didn't lose followers. I still have the same amount of followers. My TikTok account is the same. Like, it's just now a matter of starting and making your clients and followers or whatever trust you again. So first of all, in one of my previous videos, I did tell you about my dad. In December, he got sick. I left everything. I went back to my hometown. Then when I came back in May. A lot of things happened because I went through mentally so much that I wasn't expecting. And this doesn't even have to do with my dad anymore. It's just bad decisions that you make that just fuck you up. You know? So that's what happened to me. I made bad decisions. I'm paying the consequences still of that decision. But it's something that I cannot continue to blame myself for. I cannot continue to be in this pity party of telling myself, oh, you did this, you did that. Now this is the consequences. No. Because at the end of the day, in my hands, I hold the power and ability to change whatever I need to change. Life doesn't come with a handbook of you're gonna have to do this in order to. No, life is about you making a decision and just trusting God. So right now, since I know that I have the steering wheel on my hand, I'm gonna make the decision and just trust it. If this approach doesn't work, I'm gonna attempt another approach until I get to the end result that I want. The life that I have right now, I despise my life. This is not the life that I want. This is not the life that I'm gonna have 10 years from now if God gives me life and health. This is not. And if I know for sure that time, consistency, persistency, hard work is gonna pay off and it's gonna give me the things that I want, I'm gonna work my ass off. If I know that that's gonna give me the life that I want, freedom. That's all I'm asking for. Freedom. I wanna have freedom of my time. And clocking in is not giving me that. I don't care what position I hold. I understand that as long as I'm clocking in and out, I'm gonna depend on somebody telling me what to do. And since I don't want that, I'm gonna change it. Okay, so that's my point of view. So going back to making bad decisions, again, stop thinking about the bad decisions that you make, but think about how can you impact your future by doing the opposite and changing those decisions and taking different approaches to what you did wrong. So those bad decisions got me into a point that I did not want to see anything that had to do with my business. As I was looking back at pictures, I would do my makeup at least 3-4 times a week, put on my lashes. Yo, the reason why I started my business is because lashes do give you a boost. Believe it or not, lashes make you feel like confident. When you're depressed or sad, it picks you up. And I stopped doing that. I got to a point that I couldn't even see my inventory because it will make me sick. It will give me so much anxiety to even go to the location that I have my business supplies. I have over 3 months paying that location and not even going. That's how bad I was. Or am, because I'm working towards it little by little, posting more about my video and working on my dreams, because at the end of the day, when I think about it, it's like, yo, this is your dream. You started this because this is your dream. The thing is too, that I'm making this video to warn you. This is highly important, what I'm going to say, and crucial for you to understand. The people that surround you is going to impact everything that you do. I don't care what you say about, oh no, my friends do not impact what I do. I know who I am and nothing is gonna change. Bro, can you understand that some people portray this vibe, this saltiness that is going to affect every project that you have? Because negativity is more powerful than positivity. Unfortunately, that's just life. So I started hanging out with the wrong people at the wrong time, and those people affected me so much mentally that I stopped my business. Again, I went from making 10K to making $0 a month. How fucked up is that? And my mom, she's Christian, and I do believe in God, and I believe that God has gotten me to this point, this rock bottom, to humble me, to make me understand that He's the one that gives, and He takes away what He feels like. To make me realize that each and every decision that you make today is going to impact your future. And as I was standing here, just figure this, like, think about you watching your life, what took you years to build, just crumbled down, and you do anything about it. That's exactly what happened to my business. I was watching how everything was just crumbled down, everything was just getting destroyed in front of my eyes, and I would do nothing to stop it. It was like as if I was trapped, and I couldn't do anything about it. And as I talk, I have such a thing, I don't know how to say it in English, on my throat. A lot of mixed emotions about it. Because it's like, damn, how could I could have prevented this. I could have tried another method. I could have posted another picture. I could have posted another video. I could have helped another client. I could have answered another DM. And I did not. And I feel like I have to make this video because if you guys are going through the same thing, just first of all, isolate yourself from everybody. Just do what you gotta do. Think about why you're doing this, why you started. Think about the future, what it is that you wanted initially. Just follow through with it. But think about this. Go on isolation and think about the reasons why everything is crumbling down. If there's somebody that you have to remove from your life, do that unapologetically. Like, you don't have to be sorry for them. You need to block someone for your peace of mind. Block them for your peace of mind. You need to stop hanging out with them because they are bad vibes. Stop hanging out with them unapologetically. You do not have to give explanations to anybody. Just stop going out. You know how, yo, can you believe that I did not know how to say no? Like, how bad that was. Yo, I've been in these four walls just contemplating things. When I've needed things from people, from those that I thought that were going to be there, nobody was there but my mom. So why in the fuck will you give a shit about what people were gonna think about you not talking to them? People that, what would they say about you not hanging out with them? Just do you, bro. Because at the end of the day, nobody's managing my business. Nobody's paying for the losses of the business or the wings of the... Nobody's paying for none of that but me and the decisions that I've made. So, that being said, remove people that do not add into your life. Because what doesn't add is subtracting you. Some people have this energy that is like a snake just throwing his thing, and it's gonna mess you up. That's why it is crucial for you to separate yourself and hang out with like-minded people. People that are going to help your business. Friends that ask you to go out every single weekend are not your friend. I have to tell you this. What are you doing spending money when you don't have it together? What are you doing out? Celebrating what? Losses? Celebrating your failure? Celebrating that you don't own your freedom? Celebrating that just to show social media how much you're doing? Yo, that's stupid. That's why I decided, you know what? I'm gonna separate myself. I'm gonna delete all my pictures. Why am I doing, like, taking pictures, showing off? Like, right now, I just gonna post anything that has to do with my business, at least for now. until I get it back up together and everything. But yo, if again, I cannot stress this enough, do not stop your dreams for anybody. And if you see that something is going wrong or you have a gut feeling about something, trust it, because 100% you're right. Okay, so that happened. I made bad decisions. My last video that I posted was back when I was in PA, like in March. It's already October, and this is the next video. It's crazy because I reached 1,000 followers, and that's when I had to post a little bit more, because after you reach the 1,000 followers, YouTube posts or engages more the people. And like, it's been crazy, and I'm so grateful to you guys. I always say this. A lot of people have not left me alone. I still receive messages of motivation. People that message me on the daily, asking me for advice. And you know the reason why I didn't sit here and make a video? The most important one is because I didn't feel like I was capable or worthy enough to film something that I was not in the right mindset to do. Let me explain that again. I didn't do it because I didn't feel worthy. Like, my life was crumbling down. Like, my life, why? I'm not gonna sit here and be a hypocrite, because this is not me. I'm not gonna sit here and pretend everything is fine, everything is going smooth, when it's not. So I decided again to just seclude myself from everything. But you know what? Doing so is not helping me. It's bringing me down even more. This is my dream, bro. It's like I'm killing myself little by doing this. So you guys deserve an explanation. This is what happened to me. Recently was the last time that I actually decided to block certain people, exclude them from my life, and just say no. Some people, they think that they control you, that they can tell you what to do, and it's not like that. You are the owner of your life, and you can do whatever you want. Do not let people that are not working on what you're working on decide for you or give you business advice when they don't even have a business. So this is where I've come. If you can refer to my last video, episode 2 on the vending machine, I told you a little bit about what happened. I thought that I was able to come back, but you guys gave me so much love, and I wasn't ready for all of this. Like, right when my TikTok went to 65K, my YouTube went to 1K, and right now, without posting video, my YouTube is at 2.5K. Yo, 2,500 plus followers. But you know what? I wasn't ready for all of this. I wasn't ready for so much love. I was not ready mentally. And it's true what they say, for fame, for whatever, for shade, you need to be ready mentally. Because with all of that came the hate, with all of that came jealousy, with all of that came haters that I allowed to come into my life to mentally fuck me up. Again, this is not a pity party video. This is not a video for you to feel bad for me. No, this is a video of motivation. This is a video of me telling you what I did wrong for you to do the opposite and try to prevent it from happening to you. And this is a video to let you know my rock bottom, and hopefully we can compare this in 5 months, 6 months, and see the difference. Because I remember the reason why I started this YouTube channel, and it was to help people, encourage people, and I cannot forget that. My first video, compare my first video to now, I bring myself down every single day for not doing what I dreamed and what I started. But bringing myself down is not helping me. So now I'm like, you know what, let me make a video and let me start catching up. So if you're new to this video or you've been on with us since we started, I encourage you to go on my Instagram, follow me, support me. I'm relaunching again. I'm having two new lash books. The same two old lash books that were the best are also launching. So it's gonna be four books. And I'm also gonna drop new lash boxes, just new things to spice it up. And you know, this is just the beginning. Little by little, we're gonna be implementing new things until we reach excellency, okay? So thank you so much for watching. And I hope this video serves as a motivation again to you know, give you the startup that you need. Start your business today, as I say. Don't leave it for tomorrow. Start today, okay? I love you so much. Spread the love. And most importantly, do not feel bad. Do not feel bad for blocking people and for letting people go. At the end of the day, this journey is only you and I. That's it. It's only you versus you. It's not you versus them. They all leave. They all leave when you need them. So thank you so much. Spread the love. Spread positivity. And I see you in the future, okay? Love you so much. Do not forget to DM me if you have any questions. Part two of this video is going to be answering your Q&A in regards to the vending machine, okay? So stay tuned. I love you much. Bye. Boom. Ah. The thing goes.